Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of The Lighthouse Family, The Whale, by Cynthia Rylant, narrated by Mark Nelson.
Chapter 1. The Family. In a lonely lighthouse there lived a family of animals who were, in fact, not lonely at all. Their lighthouse stood on top of a cliff of sharp rocks beside the sea, and it looked as if it were the most forlorn and empty place in the world standing there all alone. But if one drew closer to this lighthouse, everything about it changed. For there were blue petunias growing in window boxes at the little cottage next door. In the yard, sunflowers lined a lovely picket fence, and tomatoes and carrots grew in the garden. At the base of the lighthouse was a handmade wooden wagon filled with toys, and the toys themselves were handmade. Penguins that wobbled, pelicans with large beaks that opened and closed, crabs with movable clicking legs. If one drew even closer to the front door of the keeper's cottage, the smell of fresh baked bread or buried dumplings floated out onto the wind. And looking inside this open door, there one would find the happiest family in the world. They were Pandora the cat, Sebold the dog, and three mouse children, Whistler, Lila, and their baby sister, Tiny. They had lived there together for less than a year, but already they had made it a home. On this particular summer day, Whistler and Lila were preparing for a shell-gathering trip along the beach. Whistler had a project. "We are going to collect broken clamshells," he told Pandora the cat as she refilled his cup with warm ginger tea. "And then I am going to build a birdhouse and decorate it with the shells and put it on a post in the garden." "Lovely," Pandora purred. "It will have the feeling of the sea and the birds will be happy." "It was my idea," said Whistler's sister, Lila. "It's true," said Whistler. "Lila thought of it. I'm simply carrying it out." "Wonderful," Pandora said. "But I'll help collect the shells," said Lila. "Then I have to finish sewing an apron for my doll." Lila held up a small wooden mouse doll. It had a tiny blue bonnet, large painted eyes, and a simple flowered dress. It looked a bit like Lila herself. "I do love summertime, don't you?" Pandora purred happily, slicing another piece of brown bread for Whistler. "Oh, yes," said Lila. Whistler nodded vigorously. "And," said Lila, "I love summertime better here than any other place in the world." Hearing this warmed Pandora's heart. Some days she could not quite believe she had been blessed with this little family, for she had first lived all alone at the lighthouse. For 4 long years she had baked bread for none but herself, poured tea for no one else, and kept the great lamp shining without the help of another. But all that changed when a dog named Sebold and his broken boat washed ashore one day. For Sebold stayed on with Pandora while his injured leg mended, through fall, then winter, then into spring. As he repaired his beloved boat, Sebold thought surely he would return to the ocean and again sail the wide world. But then one day they found the children, orphans, floating in a crate and lost, and Pandora and Sebold took them in. They tended to these little ones, cared and cooked for them, tucked them in each evening, and welcomed them awake in morning. And of course, in time, something very important changed. Their hearts. For the three mouse children made of this cottage and its solitary lighthouse a real home. With stories to tell, bread to bake, flowers to grow, games to play. And Siebold, who had thought he would always live a solitary life, could not leave. For he was a family dog now, and he was needed. As Whistler and Lila finished their bread and tea this summer morning, Siebold took Tiny to the lagoon.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.